Okay, so we came here. Now, what we needed to do is to actually look at the, I'm given the durations which we have discussed here. So, in the beam casting, for example, I've given you A and B, okay, which is for the first set of three and the second set of three. Okay, now, I want to take this also for a discussion, after we take a little bit here, take a little bit of discussion on this issue. Let's look at the predecessors. Okay, just we have started discussing this in the earlier lecture, but we will take it up now. We have order deliver piles is start, cast beams is start, there is no predecessor as such. Okay, driving piles is after my delivery. Okay, I can construct the pile cap only after driving. Okay, east abutment after pile cap, pile center after delivery. Okay, pile cap after that, the center pier after the pile cap is done, piles west, yes, okay, and one, okay, drive, construct west pile cap. Okay, now we east span.
And
yeah, so my beam should be available.
Yeah, beam.
Okay, the beam should be available and the east abutment should be ready and the center pier should be. Okay, now west, my beam should be available, center pier, west abutment, deck slab east is based on the east, west is based on the beams in the west, and then lay roads after the east and west deck slabs are done. Okay, so this is a finish start relationship predecessor. Now you can see that in this particular case, now do you think, so one thing I would like, I mean, to you to check is, does breaking the cast beam into two activities make an influence here? What in, no, so you can answer yes only if the duration makes a difference. Okay, if I took it as one activity, what would be my duration? 20. Okay, which means I could start placing east span only after 20 days, but physically 16. Okay, so the abstraction level of an activity can really control the way you can execute a project, because the network need not represent the reality on the project. We talked about level of detail of activities, remember. Okay, so here the more level of detail I go, I might be able to represent the project better. Okay, this particular case it will depend on, see this is 20 days here, you know, it is very likely to take more than 20 days, only a calculation can say that. Okay, so what is early start of place beam east span? If the early start is anywhere close to 17, 18, then this makes difference. If it is not, this split does not make a difference. Okay, so there are issues like that which will come up time and again on networks. Should I break a network into, break an activity into smaller activities so that I can get relationships better? Or we talked a little bit about start-start relationships. Or should I use start-start relationship in a precedence diagramming kind of an approach? Okay, so these are really the tricky issues, or what you can call moving away from the science, the art of planning. Okay, how do I represent, what activities do I represent in the network so that I do not blow up into thousands of activities, many of which do not need to be represented. How do I make the network appropriately represent the project I am doing? If a change in the network should be reflected in the project, a change in the project should be easily capturable in the network. Network to project should have a good, they should be representative of each other, and these are issues that make it like that. Okay, so as an exercise, you should, I want you to draw the network, do the network analysis and come up with suggestions, okay, you know, on either the way the duration was estimated or the predecessor relationships or anything else. Okay, so you can use this as a base. This shows the basic network. Okay, I want to end with one question. You can see here that we have based on the relationships, we have predecessors, we have done, we have you know, we have activity piles are delivered, and then we have 3, 6, and 9, which is driving the pile. So as per this network, it looks like we can do 3, 6, and 9 together. Yeah, does this mean it can be, so let's say I only have one piling rig, should I change the network?
Yes.
Okay, so this is something we will take up more when we talk about resource allocation, because piling rig is a resource, okay, and the danger of changing the network to match your resource, not only everything downstream gets changed, that let's say now I get a second piling rig, what will happen? I have to again go back and change my network. So the network logic should ideally not be dictated by your resource availability. And you know, if you are not going to resource load your network, then yes, you have to put resource constraint as a part of your network logic. But the minute you include resources into your network planning you know, scope, then if you constrain your network with the resource availability logic, you will find it's a very, very difficult thing to manage. You're not making the full use of the resource allocation capabilities of a network procedure. Okay, we will certainly take this up in much more detail later, but I just wanted to introduce it to you here, because we are still talking about predecessor relationship, and it's always tempting to constrain a predecessor relationship with the resource constraints you have. Any questions?
Why not then just halt the scheduling process? Once you are only aware of all your resources, then you go ahead with the scheduling.
No, but why would you do that?
Because you can avoid all these kind of.
No, but do you want to make your resource, you know, network resource? No, do you want to include resource constraint in your precedence relationship?
I want to make it independent of.
So you make it then just depend. So then we come to the question: what should the precedence relationship be based on? What is it in this case? What is it governed by?
We've assumed that there are 3 pile rigs.
No, we are not assumed there are 3 pile.
That's the only reason why 3, 6, and 9 are running parallelly, right?
Right now, 3, 6, and 9 are running parallelly because we are not planning to resource load it at this stage. That's why you see think they are running parallel. But in the minute we resource load it, it will adjust itself. Okay, so this is something to keep in mind. Basic CPM does not talk about resource, and this is where concepts like critical chain planning and everything else come in, because ultimately without resources you are not going to be able to achieve whatever duration you want, achieve whatever productivity you want, you know, all of that. So resources and even your large level sequence is governed by resources. So actually come back to the basic question, what in the way we are discussing, what should your network logic be driven by? What, no, activity yes, what should the logic be driven by? In this case, what is our logic driven by? What is the fact that we say if, you know, that 3, 6 and 9 should follow 1?
Physical
constraint, yeah. That unless I have 1 ready, I cannot do, that is 1. Second is construction method. Okay, if I prefab, say, you know, if I did from prefab versus this versus that, the method makes a big difference. Okay, so for example, here we have said earthwork will get done at a different sequence, or the roads will get done in a different sequence. The method makes a big difference. And when we say that, for example, activity 12 can be done only if 2, 5 and 8 are done. What is 5 and 8? Why are 5 and 8 predecessors to 12?
Because if there is no support.
Right. It is a physical constraint again. Okay, so ideally network logic should be based on such constraints. Okay, resource constraint should not be brought into the network logic, especially when we start loading our network with resources, it will take care of it. When we do a calculation on this right now with what we have covered so far, yes, with resource and with, if you do not put the resource logic in it, there will be a different answer from when you actually put resource driven logic into the network. But it is, this is only for hand calculation. We have to look at the larger picture. Okay, so these are the points I would also like you to think about before the next lecture. What are the resources needed for each activity? How does resource affect duration? We discussed this a little bit. So in which activity does resource affect duration? Okay, should resource availability affect precedence relationship? We have just had a discussion on this. And how can duration of a project be reduced? So this is, we will take this in a lot more detail. We have a specialized method for this called crashing. We will take this in more detail later, but I think these points should be discussed at this stage itself, and then we get into detail as we go through the different issues. We will be continuing this discussion on this bridge case, okay, and raise more issues with respect to this. Okay.